Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about duloxetine. What is this drug duloxetine? Duloxetine is a drug related to serotonin as well as norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor, commonly known as SNRI. This drug inhibits the reuptake of both norepinephrine as well as 5-HT, that is serotonin. That's why it is called as SNRI, serotonin and norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. And here, by the suffix, we cannot classify this drug into SNRI because we have few of the other drugs with similar suffix, such as fluoxetine, paroxetine. Both of these drugs are not SNRIs, they are SSRIs, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. So these two drugs are going to inhibit reuptake of serotonin only without any significant activity on reuptake of norepinephrine. So even these drugs are having the similar suffix, they are not completely equivalent to duloxetine. So duloxetine is an SNRI which inhibits the reuptake of both norepinephrine as well as serotonin. So today in this video we are going to discuss about this duloxetine, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, drug interactions, contraindications, side effects, and clinical use of this drug we will discuss in this video. So duloxetine is one of the drugs which is having wide clinical uses. Mainly this drug is indicated to treat major depressive disorder, MDD. So this is the mental disorder where the patient can have few of the depressive symptoms such as pessimism, feeling of guilt, lack of initiation, insomnia, loss of appetite. All these symptoms are collectively called as major depressive disorder. In such conditions, duloxetine can be prescribed. Similarly, this drug can also be used in the anxiety disorder. Particularly, duloxetine is useful in the treatment of generalized anxiety disorder, GAD. This is one of the anxiety disorder without any proper reason. In such conditions, duloxetine can be used. Similarly, another clinical indication of duloxetine is in the painful conditions. Since this drug is an SNRI, duloxetine can be used for few of the pain disorders such as fibromyalgia. We have another drug like venlafaxine, which is also used in the fibromyalgia, which is again SNRI. And another important indication of duloxetine is that this drug is useful in diabetic peripheral neuropathic pain. So neuropathic pain is the pain produced within the neurons without any external damage, and this neuropathic pain is associated with the diabetic neuropathy. In such conditions, duloxetine can be used to control the neuropathic pain, and this drug can also be used to treat chronic musculoskeletal pain. In this way, duloxetine is one of the drugs which is used as antidepressant as well as anxiolytic, and it can also be used to control the pain conditions associated with the central nervous system. Now let us see the chemical nature of this duloxetine. So this is the structure of duloxetine, and here the amine is the principal functional group. So we can start the numbering from the amine. So this is 1, 2, 3. This amine group is attached to the propyl chain. So the suffix of the name is propane-1-amine. Now to this propanamine, at the third position, one of the heterocyclic ring system is present. This is nothing but thiophene. Let us give the numbering to this thiophene. This is 1, this is 2. Now thiophene is attached by second position to the third position of the main chain. So we can write this as 3-thiophene-2-aryl. Similarly, at the third position, naphthalene ring is attached through the oxygen. So we can write this as 3-naphthalene-1-aryl-oxy. And finally, one of the methyl group is present on the amine group. So it is N-methyl. This is the complete name of duloxetine. Now let us see how this drug acts. So within the central nervous system, norepinephrine is one of the important mediators which can be released, and it can act on the postsynaptic neurons. At the postsynaptic neurons, adrenergic receptors are present such as alpha or beta receptors, And this norepinephrine can be released by calcium-mediated exocytosis. So when the action potential reaches to the presynaptic neurons, calcium can enter and it can produce the exocytosis and release of norepinephrine. And this norepinephrine can bind to norepinephrine receptors, resulting in the postsynaptic stimulation. But the action of norepinephrine can be controlled by its reuptake into the nerve terminal. Here, one of the transporters is present, NAT, norepinephrine transporter. Through this transporter, norepinephrine can be uptaken into the nerve terminals. In this way, the action of norepinephrine depends on its reuptake into the nerve terminal. Similarly, another important mediator within the CNS is the serotonin. Again, at the postsynaptic neurons, serotoninergic receptors are present, such as 5-HT2 receptors. Now, this 5-HT can be released and can act on the 5-HT2 receptors to produce postsynaptic stimulation. Just like the norepinephrine, the action of 5-HT is again controlled by its reuptake into the nerve terminal. So, one of the transporters is present. This is the serotonin transporter. Through this transporter, serotonin can be reuptaken into the nerve terminal. So, again, the action of serotonin can be controlled by its reuptake into the nerve terminal. Now, here, duloxetine can act on both norepinephrine as well as 5-HT neurons. That's why it is called SNRI, serotonin as well as norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. This drug can bind to this norepinephrine transporter, thereby it can inhibit its activity so that norepinephrine cannot enter the nerve terminals, which results in the accumulation of norepinephrine within the synaptic cleft. Similarly, duloxetine can also block serotonin transporter so that serotonin cannot be uptaken into the nerve terminals. By these actions, duloxetine can increase the levels of norepinephrine as well as 5-HT within the CNS, which improves the symptoms of depression as well as pain disorders such as fibromyalgia and neuropathic pain. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions of duloxetine is that this drug can produce hepatotoxicity in the patients. So when this drug is going to be prescribed, after 2 months of the treatment, hepatotoxicity may be developed and few of the symptoms can be observed in the patients, such as abdominal pain, hepatomegaly, enlargement of the liver, and cholestatic jaundice. Similarly, increased transaminase levels, such as increased ALT, alanine transaminase, increased AST, aspartate transaminase. So these liver enzymes are elevated because of duloxetine, which indicates hepatic injury. So this drug should be carefully given in the patients who are having the more risk for hepatic damage. Just like other SSRIs as well as SNRIs, this drug can also precipitate serotonin syndrome. So this is one of the syndrome which is associated with increased 5-HT levels. So when this drug is given with other drugs which increase the further levels of 5-HT, it may lead to severe serotonin syndrome. So few of the drugs like SSRIs, such as fluoxetine, paroxetine. Similarly, SNRIs such as escitalopram, venlafaxine. MAO inhibitors like phenylgene, tranylcypromine, and isocarboxate. These MAO inhibitors can inhibit the metabolism of 5-HT, thereby increase the 5-HT levels. And triptan drugs, which are used to treat the migraine, such as sumatriptan. All these drugs can further increase the serotonin syndrome when they are given with duloxetine. So within this syndrome, the patients can observe few of the symptoms such as agitation, hallucinations, confusion, anxiety, and some tachycardia, increased heart rate, hyperthermia, increased body temperature, diaphoresis, sweating, flushing, tremor, and muscle rigidity in the patients. Another important precaution of duloxetine is that this drug can produce orthostatic hypotension. This orthostatic hypotension may lead to syncope in the patients. This condition can be observed within first week of treatment, so caution should be taken in order to prevent orthostatic hypotension as well as syncope in the patients. And when the patient is treated with other vasodilators such as calcium channel blockers, CCBs, as well as alpha blockers, they can further increase the orthostatic hypotension. Similarly, duloxetine can increase the risk of bleeding in the patients. So this may lead to ecchymosis, the pooling of the blood under the skin, epistaxis, nasal bleeding, hematoma, blood in the urine, as well as gastrointestinal bleeding. All these can be observed with duloxetine along with other SSRIs as well as SNRIs. And this risk of bleeding can be further increased with other drugs such as aspirin, warfarin and NSAIDs. All these drugs can increase the risk of bleeding when they are combined with duloxetine. Another important precaution of duloxetine, commonly observed with many of the antidepressants, is the risk of suicidal initiation. So adolescents with age less than 18 years and young patients with age 18 to 24 years, there is an increased risk of suicidal initiation. In these patients, we can observe few of the symptoms such as anxiety, agitation, irritability, some aggressiveness, restlessness, insomnia. All these can further increase the risk of suicidal initiation. So duloxetine should be carefully given to these patients. Similarly, another important precaution is that this drug is used as an antidepressant. So this drug can produce some manic phase in the patients. Otherwise, it can also produce hypomania due to fluctuations of the 5-HT levels as well as norepinephrine levels within the CNS. And this drug can also increase your urinary retention. Finally, it can also induce the seizures in the patients. Just like other agents, duloxetine can also increase the neuroleptic malignant syndrome. So it may produce muscle rigidity and hyperthermia, some confusion in the patients. And particularly, this risk is more pronounced with other drugs like dopamine antagonists. Duloxetine can also produce the hyponatremia and the serum sodium levels may be reduced less than 110 millimoles per liter. This results in few of the symptoms such as headache, confusion, impaired memory as well as weakness in the patients. And this hyponatremia produced by duloxetine is mainly attributed to inhibitory effect on antidiuretic hormone. So when this antidiuretic hormone is not working properly, it increases the diuresis, which results in the decreased serum sodium levels. And in the patients who are having the volume depletion, otherwise the patients using loop diuretics or elder patients, they may have further risk of hyponatremia when they are prescribed with duloxetine. What are the drug interactions? Duloxetine is going to be metabolized by cytochrome P450 system. One of the important metabolic enzyme is CYP1A2. So if you have the drugs like fluoxamine, cimetidine, which is a H2 antagonist, ciprofloxacin, enoxazine, these two are quinoline antibiotics. All these drugs can inhibit the CYP1A2 activity, thereby they can increase the duloxetine levels within the serum. Similarly, this drug is also metabolized by CYP2D6. Few of the drugs like paroxetine, fluoxetine and quinidine, they can inhibit the activity of CYP2D6, thereby they inhibit the metabolism of duloxetine. And here fluoxamine can block both CYP1A2 as well as CYP2D6, which significantly inhibits the metabolism of duloxetine, thereby increase the serum levels of duloxetine to a higher level. So again, these drug interactions should be closely monitored when this duloxetine is given with these drugs. Duloxetine is metabolized by CYP2D6, but at the same time, this drug is also inhibit the activity of CYP2D6. So this drug can inhibit the metabolism and increase the serum levels of other drugs such as nortriptyline, imipramine, imipramine, all these are TCAs. Similarly, phenothiazine antipsychotics like chlorpromazine and thioredazine, class 1C antiarrhythmics like propafenone, flecainide, all these drugs are affected by duloxetine and their levels are increased in presence of duloxetine. And particularly, thioredazine is contraindicated with the duloxetine because of this drug interaction. What are the contraindications? This drug duloxetine can increase the mydriasis pupillary dilatation, which may increase the intraocular pressure. So it is contraindicated in uncontrolled narrow angle glaucoma. Similarly, this drug can precipitate serotonin syndrome. So it is contraindicated with MAO inhibitors, which are inhibiting the metabolism of 5-HT. Thereby, they further increase the serotonin syndrome. Now, let us see the side effects of duloxetine. The important side effects mainly include dry mouth, nausea, somnolence, fatigue, constipation, some loss of appetite, dizziness, headache, palpitations, blurred vision, paresthesias, loss of sensation. and hyperhidrosis, increased sweating in the patients can be observed. How it is given? This drug is available as delayed release capsule, and it is available at different strengths like 20 mg, 30 mg, 40 mg as well as 60 mg. The dose of the drug depends on the type of clinical indication. For the treatment of major depressive disorder, the starting dose of this drug is 20 to 30 mg twice daily. That means the dose per day is variable from 40 to 60 mg. And the maximum dose that can be achieved is 120 mg per day. Similarly, for the treatment of generalized anxiety disorder as well as neuropathic pain, the initial dose is 60 mg once daily. So the starting dose is same for both major depressive disorder as well as generalized anxiety disorder. 60 mg is given once daily. For the treatment of fibromyalgia as well as other musculoskeletal disorders, the initial dose is 30 mg once daily, but the dose can be increased up to 60 mg per day. So in all these clinical conditions, the 60 mg per day is the one of the suitable dose which is effective. So that's about this duloxetine. Duloxetine is an SNRI, serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitor. This drug inhibits the reuptake of both norepinephrine as well as 5-HT, thereby it increases their levels within the CNS, which results in the antidepressant activity as well as reducing the pain stimulation within the CNS. So this drug is useful in the treatment of major depressive disorder as well as generalized anxiety disorder. It can also be useful in the pain disorders such as fibromyalgia, diabetic peripheral neuropathic pain, and chronic musculoskeletal pain disorders. In all these conditions, duloxetine can be used. This drug may produce hepatotoxicity in the patients, so care should be taken in the patients who are having the risk of hepatic failure. And it can also produce orthostatic hypotension and syncope. So along with other vasodilators, this drug should be carefully given. Just like the other drugs within this category, this drug can also precipitate neuroleptic malignant syndrome and serotonin syndrome. It can also increase the suicidal risk in the adolescents as well as young patients. Hyponatremia is another important precaution because of inhibition of antidiuretic hormone activity. And this drug can also precipitate manic phase or hypomania, some seizures and urinary retention in the patients. This drug should be carefully given with other drugs which are inhibiting the CYP1A2 activity, such as fluoxamine, cimetidine, ciprofloxacin, and enoxacin. Similarly, CYP2D6 inhibitors such as fluoxamine, paroxetine, quinidine, they can also increase the levels of duloxetine by inhibition of its metabolism. This drug also inhibits the CYP2D6 activity, thereby it can inhibit the metabolism of many drugs such as TCAs, phenothiazines, and triptan drugs. So these drugs should be carefully combined with duloxetine. This drug is available as delayed release capsule. And for most of the disorders, the initial dose is 60 mg per day. But for fibromyalgia and other painful conditions, the initial dose may be 30 mg per day, which may be increased up to 60 mg per day. So that's about this duloxetine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.